I bought a couple of Browning camera traps and put them on my land in Thong Pha Phum, and look what we've got on the first night. This is just unbelievable. A large spotted civet coming to check the camera out here. Incredible. Apparently this species is not often seen. So this really is quite a remarkable for us to get this straight away. You can see the date and time at the bottom of the screen. Very suspicious of the camera there. And then just two nights later, absolutely amazing, large Indian civet here. This is the species that we thought we were much more likely to find. You can see the hoops on the tail of that one. Just an hour or so later in the same location, the large spotted civet back down again. Look at the tail, and a lot more black, and you don't get complete hoops encircling the tail. The lower half is fully black. Smelling around the area where the other civet was just an hour or so ago. And then following the stream up towards the spring, which is only about 30 or 40 meters away from this location. Here is the area of the spring. I've put another camera here. The water trickles out of the ground up in the top right corner among that bamboo. And this attracts wildlife year round. And here we see, this was back on that first night, and it was probably that first civet that we saw. Large spotted again. There is a water pool up there, and it appears to either be drinking or snuffling around that water pool looking for frogs or crabs. This was one of the great delights for us here. After many years of this land, when we first bought it, it was just a total wasteland. It had had a forest fire, no big trees or anything left. And we've reforested it and allowed trees to grow up. And as a result, this spring line about 5 or 6 years ago opened up again. And so there is water at this location all year round. Even 6-7 months after the last rain, there is still a little bit of water trickling out of the ground here. Once again, as you can see, the black tail, so large spotted. As I said, there is a pool up there where the civet is, but there are always piles of leaves around as well. Frogs and toads always to be found here now that the spring is flowing again. Also bear in mind that this is with infrared, so the civet itself is in the dark pretty well. But as you can see from the timestamp down below, this is early morning now. I've moved the camera. This is about 2 weeks later. And this is a much better view without that reflection that I was getting on the route before. This is the large Indian civet. You can see the full hoops of black and white on the tail there, distinguishing this species, and the very distinctive markings on the neck as well. It wasn't all civets. In fact, most of the hits on these cameras were from rats triggering the cameras again and again and again at night. So I've included a few of those clips into this compilation. Very noticeable, though, that there's not a rat in sight every single time the civets come. Again, this is the large Indian civet. You can see the tail there with those black and white hoops. And it is suspicious of the camera. Unfortunately, the lights on the camera do glow a little bit red when the infrared system turns on, and in the dark that must be quite distinctive. This civet is sniffing the air in the direction of the camera. But I'm hoping over time that they will become accustomed to this and take no further notice. And indeed, just, what is this, half an hour later, I think? It seems to have lost interest. I can't believe that in just 15 years we've managed to transform, or this land has transformed itself back to a state of nature like this. Just absolutely stunning. Look at the pattern on the throat of this one. I've been looking at different individuals, and we certainly have more than one coming here. Looks like he's getting a good drink in one of the pools down among the bamboo leaves there. I've seen several snakes in this location during the daytime when I've been sat in a hide here, and indeed I plan to make a permanent hide just back behind the view of where the camera is now, and slowly introduce lights onto that hide and see if it's possible to use this area for nighttime wildlife viewing. Now, this is the next day, so bear in mind, as I said, this civet is pretty well in the dark, but nonetheless, I think it managed to get that frog. Incredible. We know they also eat crabs. The first time we were aware that they were on the land a few years ago was when one of our ponds was drying out and something came in the night and dug out a lot of crabs, and we found all the bits of broken shell around there and very distinctive large civet paw prints. Back to the rat circus that goes on most of the time during the night. And on the left-hand side here, I think this male attempting to mate, but being rebuffed. This is a new location now. We're calling this area Turtle Pool. The little depression in front of the camera, and then that leads away to the left, does fill up with water in the rainy season, and I've seen turtles here, but most of the year it's very dry, so we've made this little artificial pool in the center of the picture, and we have a dribble of water coming down the gully above to provide fresh water each day to that pool, and it has become very, very popular. Bearing in mind, this video is only the mammal clips that I've picked up. I also picked up a huge number of bird clips at this location and the other locations that I've shown, and that will be the subject of a separate video. So if you would like to see that, please make sure you subscribe and press the bell icon, and in that way you'll get notifications of that future clip and all other future clips as well. Birdmore's ground squirrel there on the left, and again, these were frequent visitors to this pool, late in the day or early morning quite often. And here is the second of the artificial pools that we have made, again with the Berdmores. And look above, on the left side, you can see I've set up an artificial hide. I will be making a proper hide there, but I just wanted to set that up so the animals get used to something being there. We're calling this area Rocky Pool, for very obvious reasons. And this is a very dry part of the land. Streams flow here for about 3 months of the year, just in the height of the rainy season. But outside of that, there is no water supply. Back to turtle pool now, and another large spotted civet, but this one to my eyes looks different to the ones that I've seen before. Perhaps I'm mistaken. Look closely as it gets to the top of the pool. There, it sprays on the vegetation. But it doesn't seem to have put these rats off at all. I'm guessing this is two males having a territorial fight. Not interested at all in the smell of civet. And here, a brief glimpse also of a large spotted civet over at Rocky Pool as well on the other side of our land. Fantastic. That means we have picked up civets now in all of the locations on the main part of the land that we've put cameras down in. And I've frozen the picture here just to illustrate something very frustrating about these Browning camera traps. Look how far this civet is into the picture before the motion sensor has picked it up. And the very next night, a large spotted civet in the same area. Again, a large spotted civet, and it has clocked the camera. I've frozen the picture again. You can see it staring straight at it. It's picked up the infrared lights coming on, and it did not like it. And then, what a surprise! A wild boar, or is it? Look at those straps around its body. It has been kept as a pet at some time in the past. And we subsequently learned that people in a village near here kept one as a pet, and it escaped about a year ago. I am assuming it is this one. And we have now made a spring door trap, and we are putting food out in the hope that we can trap this pig and get that awful strap off of it. And it is welcome then to live on our land for as long as it likes. Still at Turtle Pool, and this large Indian civet seems to be behaving very cautiously. I wonder if it's picked up the sound of another civet or perhaps some prey animal. As you can see, this is July now. We've had plenty of rain, but the wildlife still seems to prefer to come to drink at the pools that we have made, and that is very gratifying indeed. And just a few days later, another large Indian civet, but clearly a different individual, and a very striking neck pattern here. I believe the same as the two so far that we have seen over at the spring area. And here a lovely view of this large spotted civet. Look at the black down the back there, and then the black all the way down the back of the tail, and the lower half of the tail completely black, no hoops. Daytime shot, late in the afternoon. These northern tree shrews and also the Berdmore's ground squirrel like to come and drink. And here's one of the guys that I work with here that helped set up this pool, and he comes regularly to clean it out and get the leaves out and just check the water supply. His name is Men, which means porcupine, and if you're interested in porcupines, stay tuned, because we had an amazing surprise in the following month when we moved one of the cameras up into a different area. As you can see, getting the leaves out so that the water doesn't go stagnant, and just checking the line of sight of the camera. This is now up on the top area of our land. There is a Burmese hare, you can see, that is not fire, but mist, which we frequently get up on the higher part of the land when the temperatures fall at night. This whole area that you can see is actually meant to be a large pool, but it has not been successful. We have tried and tried to dig this out. We do have a bit of water there that you can see, because it is raining quite often now, but really I wanted this whole area to form a large pool that would see us through the dry season. because this part of the land has no water available at all outside of rain. And I think it would really help to encourage more wildlife to stay up here if we had a water supply through the dry season. And now my nemesis, this is an absolute disaster for us at the moment. I do like dogs, but these ones are most unwelcome. They don't have owners, they've just been dumped, probably by migrant workers, and they've started to come into the land and hunt the hares and other animals. Nobody feeds these dogs, of course, and you can see this one's trying to dig something up. And for the whole week after this particular clip, I got nothing at this location. I was getting hares, pigs, and civets regularly before that, but they have come in and really upset the wildlife here. As a result, I've got no choice but to start to put dog-proof fencing all the way around the land at great expense. So far, we've spent about 60,000 baht. It's terrible. I'd much rather spend that money on camera traps or on hides. And of course, it also means that many of the large animals that we would like to give sanctuary to in the land won't be able to get in. But there is no other solution that I can see. I know of other people who poison or shoot dogs. I'm a vegan, I'm not going to do that. But they really are undermining everything that we're trying to do here. So I've got to keep them out. Back to Turtle Pool now, and this is August and you can see it is flooded. I've turned the camera around. It's on the same tree that was aiming at our little freshwater pool. And I'm pointing it at the bank on the side here, just in the hope that we get some animals walking along this bank at night. But I did not expect this. A leopard cat. Unbelievable. Absolutely amazing. But then my excitement was tempered when I saw that it was limping. And in fact, its front left paw, as you can see here, appears to be bent back, and perhaps his leg is even broken. We've started to put food down now for this cat in the hope that we can help it. It may not be able to hunt. And I mentioned porcupines, and here we are. We've moved the camera, one of the cameras, up onto the limestone hills above our rubber plantation. That's a different one there. You can see dots on the tails of these porcupines. And in the first few nights, we had three different ones go past the camera. Lots of rats, of course, as you would expect, and the normal tree shrew here. This is a pathway down the hill next to this limestone rock. Here's the third of the porcupines. These are brush-tailed porcupines, not the ones that you might be more familiar with. And here on the right-hand side, another stunning surprise. I've frozen the frame again so you can have a little look at it. Another leopard cat. Incredible. We're so excited now. As you can see, rain falling. It is raining most of the time at the moment, and the date, in fact, and time of the camera has stopped working. This is early September. And here another freeze frame on the right-hand side there. The last of the new species that we've captured in this round of camera trapping, a large bamboo rat. Absolutely fantastic. Can't wait to do some more.